on that fucking nigga shit.
So today I am bringing y'all back with a story time. I know y'all love my story times, so of course I have to bring it back. In the back, my daughter's watching a movie, so she's keeping herself entertained. So if you hear the background, then that's what it is. But yeah, let's just get started with the video. Ooh, people must have. So by the title of this video, I'm guessing y'all should already know what I'm gonna talk about. Yeah, the story time of me almost killing myself over a boy. Literally, legit, guys. I tried to kill myself. Okay. Oh my god, this is gonna be so weird because I feel like everybody's gonna know who I'm talking about. Like, if you know, you know, all right? But let me take this off because I'm making too much noise. So I was around 13, I would say, and I had my first boyfriend at 13, and you know, it was like, you know, the first love, blah blah, little puppy love, whatever. So it was around school year, and me and this boy, we were already dating for, I would say, a good month or two. Before that, we were talking. So we were dating, whatever, we went to the same school, and I was like in love. Like, I was fucking in love, I ain't even gonna lie. I was in love with this kid, and one day my mom just, you know, we had to move. So I broke the news to him, and I mean, we were young, he didn't give a fuck, like, you know, like, he didn't really care, like, he didn't really feel me like I was feeling him, for a fact. So he was just like, oh, like, I'm gonna miss you, whatever, yeah, whatever. He was over there cheating, so he didn't give a fuck. So yeah, he didn't really care, he was just acting like he cared, you know. So the day that I'm moving, it rolls around, right? It's a school day. Keep in mind, I was not gonna break up with him. I was just gonna be like, okay, like, maybe some days I could come on the weekends and see him, you know, whatever. But he was just like, you know, like, I'm not gonna be able to see you no more. I'm not gonna be able to see you no more. It's, you know, it's not gonna be the same. So I think we're gonna have to break up and ta-da-da-da. Like, are you moving or am I moving? Like, the fuck? So he's telling me that, whatever, we're walking out of school and we're going to a food place that's right by the school. We go, and my mom telling me, like, that's the same day that we're gonna move. So my mom's telling me, you know, tell him goodbye already because we're moving. I'll pick you up right now when you get off of school. So we were, oh, sorry, I'm messing with my hair. Hold on. We're already leaving school, and you know, mom's gonna meet me up at this food place, and she's just telling me to tell him, like, goodbye, you know, whatever. And before she pulls up, he tells me, like, we're inside, and he tells me, like, it's gonna be over, like, I'm gonna miss you, I love you, and I wish nothing the best for you. And then I was just like crying, but not really crying, I was just like sad, you know, sad. I was like, damn, like, this is really happening. My little 13 year old ass is a heartbroken, thinking my life is over, and ta-da-da-da. So my mom pulls up, and she's like, you know, we gotta go, tell your little boyfriend bye, blah blah blah. So I'm like crying, and I'm like, we're giving each other a hug, and this is like the worst feeling I ever felt in my life. This is probably the first heartbreak of my life. So I'm crying, and he's just like, nothing, like, he's just like, it's gonna be okay, blah, blah, blah. Whatever. Alright, so now to the juicy part. So we're on our way to, you know, our new home. And while we're in the way, guys, I'm like literally like crying, like, si me picaron el pinche culo, I swear. Like, dude, I was crying like it was the end of the world and I was gonna die, okay? I was crying. So I'm telling my mom, like, crying, I'm like, mommy, I'm like, take me back, I don't want to go, you know, I'm freaking freaking out. Like, I'm even freaking out. I'm thinking this is the end of the world. So I'm legit telling her, like, mommy, take me back, take me back, take me back. Like, crying, like, hysterical crying, okay? So I'm like, take me back, mom, come on. So I'm telling her all this, crying, right? And my sister's in the car. My sister Paola, she's in the car with us. And she's like, no, Elisa, no te voy a llevar. You're being dramatic. Like, yeah. Lo vas a ver después. And I'm like, no, mommy, take me back, please. So she's just talking shit now, because now she's just, you know, I'm just being a little 13-year-old, you know, dramatic. I'm being like, you know, I'm being stupid. So she gets mad at this point. She's like, yeah, Elisa, like, you need to come down. And I'm like, no, like, so I'm getting mad because she's not feeling sorry for me, okay? She's not feeling sorry. Basically telling me I'm being a little stupid ass, which I am, which I was. And so now that I know that she's really getting pissed off, dude, this is where I fucked up. So I, like, okay, we're on the freeway, and I'm like, ma, si no me vas para atrás, I'm gonna jump out the door. And I'm telling her, and she's just not believing me. She thinks I'm being dramatic. So I'm like, I was like, you're a fucking bitch. And she fucking slaps me. She fucking slaps me in my face. Cause I'm like, you're a fucking bitch. You don't want to take me back. Da, da, da. So she slaps me because I called her that. And I would never call my mom that. Like, I was literally, this is the one and only time I ever called her that. Aprendí con esa primera cachetada, you know what I'm saying? So then I got mad because she slapped me. So I opened the door. Oh my God, this is this is giving me so many memories. So I opened the door, guys. I literally opened that shit. Like, you know, like, I opened that shit, and I'm about to fucking jump out and suicide myself over this kid that didn't give a fuck about me. So I opened the door, and mi mamá me jala, bro. She, like, fucking, I don't know. She was driving hella fast, okay? And I don't know, she managed to yank my ass back in the fucking seat. And, bro, I was literally about to kill myself. Like, kill myself. I wouldn't be here right now. Like, I don't comprehend what I was about to do at the moment. Like, I was literally about to take my own life. Like, what would my mom say? Like, oh, sis, she jumped out the car because no la dejé go back and see da-da-da whatever's face y pues se mató. Like, how do you explain that? Like, how do you explain that without being like, what the fuck? But yeah, she literally chinked my ass, and she had a cup of McDonald's with ice. She opened that shit and she threw it at me. And she's like, get the pasa, pendeja, get the pasa. She's going off on me because, dude, I was literally about to kill myself. Like, I was legit about to die. And she's like, get the pasa, pendeja. And I'm like crying. And my little sister Paola is crying in the background. Like, you know, because I was literally about to kill myself, bro. Like, I was legit about to kill myself. And I'm like, mommy, es que tú no me entiendes. Yo lo quiero. I love it. But she's like, no, pendeja. Da, da, da. Like, ¿qué te pasa? Like, I don't know. She's just hella mad. She locks the doors. And I'm just crying. And so, yeah. That was the worst thing ever. Because, like, years down the road, I talked to the kid again. So it was just like, bro, I was legit about to kill myself for you, but I never told him. Yeah, it was just crazy. Like, that's just crazy. I was about to kill myself for this kid, bro. But yeah, I remembered, like, I was thinking of story times to tell y'all, like, what happened in my life, which I have a lot. But I was just thinking of something for right now. And then my sister, a couple days ago, or like a couple weeks ago, she brought up, tell the story time when you were gonna kill yourself for da, 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 da. And I was like, bro, yes, like, that shit would be so funny. And I was just like, ay, pendeja, you know, just like, okay. So I decided to today to tell it. Word of advice, guys, if you're under the age of 18 and your man leaves you, don't think it's another world. Like, don't think then it's the end of the world, because I have a kid, and, you know, me and my baby daddy got problems. But at the end of the day, hay muchos pajaritos en el mundo. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, know your worth. Like, don't think, I know it's like the most heartbreaking thing that could ever be. You know, you're gonna go through your heartbreaks, but dude, it's never that serious. Like, I never knew how to tell myself it's not that serious when I had relationships and, you know, we broke up. Like, I never was able to tell myself it's not that serious. Like, bro, like, move the fuck on. Life goes on. Like, they always come back, basically. They always come back later or sooner than later. Like, they always come back. So it's like, bro, it's not even worth it. But then I had my baby, and then, like, it made me think so different about life that I'm just like, bro, like, I was so dumb. But yeah, this is a story time about me almost killing myself over this kid, bro. Oh my god. And hold on, let me tell you something real quick. I'm about to rant on you bitches. Okay, so my last story time, which was the what was it? Oh, when my mom cut my hair bald. So the last, I only have like 2 story times on my video, on my channel. And people are always commenting like, I don't believe until I see pictures. I don't believe it. Like, oh, you're making up the story. Like, this sounds so, how do you say, scripted and da da da. And I'm like, bro, like, y'all want me to share story times with y'all, but then when I do, y'all think I'm being scripted or I'm lying. Like, bro, how am I gonna lie about shit like this? Like, y'all weird if y'all lie about shit that happened in your life. There's no reason to lie. I just like to tell y'all my story times, you know, for you to enjoy, for entertainment, for other people to laugh at, you know, at my past and stuff that I did. What I wanted to say real quick, because I seen comments are like, oh, they're pictures, or you're lying, da da da. I have pictures when my hair was really short, when my mom cut me bald. I was gonna insert them, but I was kind of a little embarrassed, you know. So I was like, nah, I'm not gonna do it. But now that I know y'all are talking shit, or that some people don't believe me, I should have. So I would have shit to say, but whatever. That's neither here or there. You believe me or you don't. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I am gonna come back with more story times, and it gets even better. So like and subscribe to my channel. Like this video. Comment down below videos that you suggest for me. And as always, I always get back to y'all. So thank you for subscribing and taking your time watching me. And yeah, I think that's about it. Also, if you're still here, I plan on doing a Q&A, so if you have any questions for me, or if you're wondering anything about me, or just any kind of questions, comment down below your questions. So I am going to do a Q&A video. So I am going to be putting your questions on the video, hopefully. I have 2 videos ahead that I'm going to do before the Q&A. So y'all are going to have time to comment questions and everything that y'all want to know and that y'all want me to answer. So don't forget to do that. Anyways, thank you for watching. Bye guys.